Good morning, Mr. Deputy Secretary General, dear Haolin, dear directors, dear Deputy Speaker of our Parliament, Minister Grabarczyk, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ministers, regulators, delegates from ministries, the business and science sector. Dear colleagues, let me welcome you in Warsaw. It is a great honor for Poland and for me personally to have you all here as our guests. I would like to thank ITU for giving our country the opportunity to organize GSR. Also, I would like to thank President Bronisław Komorowski for extending his patronage over our conference and offering a warm welcome to our guests. I am looking forward to 3 days packed with the interesting discussion on the most significant topics, telecommunication and the internet. It goes without saying that for all people around the globe, both mobile telephony and the internet access nowadays are extremely important. Let me present a few facts to prove my point. In a survey carried out among Londoners, nearly 40% of people believe that their stress levels would be higher if we don't have surfed the web than in a situation when basic utilities like water or heating were cut off of or their TV set stopped working. On the other hand, when Americans were asked what they would give up for a year to maintain access to internet, 73% said they would ready to quit alcohol, and 21% said they would go whole year without sex. When asked to determine the worth of the internet, most US citizens say they would need to be paid roughly $2,500 to live without the internet for 1 year. Fortunately, we are lucky to have here in this hotel the internet access as well as hot water and television, so I believe our symposium will continue in reasonable and comfortable condition. What's more, I am convinced that all of us here today, we all do our best so that people won't give up anything in return for the internet access. Correct me if I am wrong, but I believe that our professional mission is to ensure that the telecommunication services, in particular access to the internet, should become commonly accessible. Their availability has to be considered a basic civil right, not a luxury. Just to emphasize the point, the UN has dealt with this issue and has been discussing the internet access as civil right. Ladies and gentlemen, as you certainly know, this year's symposium goes under the theme Fourth Generation Regulation Moving to the Next Level. Let me set out a scope of our topic, which we will discussing. What matters most is the common goal. We call achieve it regardless of where we are now. This applies to the areas with FTTH and these regions where the development of radio technologies is dominant. As a result, people of all continents and countries should and will be able to use the attributes of the global information society. And they should see themselves as its vital element. Each and every one of us here, we are a team sharing a common goal. And so it happens that this goal is the theme of our first and most important debate on adopting human-centric policies in a digital era. All discussions will account for the perspective of the business, regulators, and consumers. The consumer perspective, because the consumer is the most important, and markets, states, and regulators act according to the consumer needs. The digital society is certain future, and it is ITU's domain to work out an optimal model for its construction. Obviously, the quality of the model is directly proportional to the spectrum management. And that is what we will discuss. It is the good most desired by the operators and at the same time is the most important tools in the hands of regulators. We should take the responsibility and manage it very efficiently. This GSR is attended by more than 85% of countries having regulators. These countries are the different stage of the frequency allocation. I hope we will actively share our knowledge about the management of spectrum. And more importantly, we will start an urgent discussion about second digital dividend. Another key element to consider is the 4.0 infrastructure, particularly is its financing. How to encourage companies to invest in modern infrastructure? Probably every regulator toys with this question. With the participation of investors, bank, and representatives of rating agencies, we will hopefully come up with an answer thanks to this debate. Although we are in the telecommunications symposium, the financial aspect will be often present in our discussion. One of the topics in digital transaction, but also the overall structure of demand of digital services, as well as reaching for a new range of services. Services then can be provided thanks to new technologies. This new situation calls for new regulations and safety improvements. Also, I look forward to discussion on standards and patents in the ICT business. If you ask me, reaching a consensus to reconcile innovative companies' interest with the development of digital economy is one of the most important issues of today. An agreement on that issue will have an impact on our everyday life. As you all know, the last day of our meeting, Friday, is the Regulator's Day. In the group of regulatory authorities, we will discuss the future. The changes in the ICT market are rapid. The media and telecommunication convergence process is deepening. We are facing a transformation onto next level. New application and communication platforms have already showed up. Regulatory authorities must not only accept the fact, but should actually be co-creators of new reality. Therefore, the subject of our discussion will be the new model of regulation based on consultation and partnership, namely co-regulation. In this model, the regulator is a partner for regulated subjects, and the rules are the result of joint action. Ladies and gentlemen, telecommunication networks are the bloodstream of the world's economy. None of us can imagine today's work and daily life without the computer, telephone, or internet access. A man has become a homo smartphonus and is more and more dependent on the mobile devices. 1/3 of the world's population is connected to the internet. It means that nearly 4 billion people live offline and still cannot enjoy benefits offered by the internet. If everyone had a chance to access the net, the benefits for global economy would be incredible. We have come here from different continents. We represented different culture, different backgrounds and value system. But we have one thing in common. We all want to have permanent access to the internet because we are all confident that it guarantees development and better life. Therefore, today's broadband internet access cannot be considered as a luxury. They are a basic need for sustainable economic growth of the whole world. As regulators, we have duties, but also tools, to do everything to promote broadband internet access in our society. It cannot be successful without the cooperation with operators. I am convinced that if we really think about NGN, which requires huge investment, the dialogue with operators is necessary. In my view, currently, there is no room for strict regulation. Of course, everything depends on the level of development of given market. Therefore, the task for regulators are much more difficult, as they have to combine the duty to protect competition with the task aiming at stimulating investment. A lot of us have heard from the operators. We will invest in the NGN if you will don't regulate. Of course, we can take it on board and say, fine, don't invest. We will see where it takes you in the 5 years' time. But it is a step back for whole society, which we must take care of. Regulators have to remember about the rule. First of all, do no harm. It is not what we should do for the market, but what market should do for people with our support. Just like synapses form info highways by building connections, we have to foster connection to coexist. ITU could play key role in these actions, of course, with the support of regulators. Our goal is to create optimal conditions for broadband investment and ensure free competition, but our solution should influence not only the telecom market and its players, but also other relevant sectors such as the finance market or energy industry. I believe we do it right in Poland. Here we have set the priority to develop solutions that suit specific needs of the market. This is why we propose amendments to the law, carry out analysis of the broadband infrastructure and services, provide educational assistance for the market players, and develop our own know-how to experience of other countries. That is why I think a partnership relation among all parties of our ecosystem, the market and regulators, is necessary and is a modern approach most suitable in the 21st century. We should also remember about our role and position in the society. We are a kind of lighthouse keepers in the digitalization process and telecommunication services. Respect for the market supervision, we need to create demand for digital services. Often the problem is the lack of awareness, but about the benefits that broadband brings. The latest report of the European Commission shows that only 2% of the Europeans buy broadband access with a capacity of 100 megabits per second or faster. This is an alarming low rate and shows that staggering amount of work ahead of us. To recap, once again, I would like to thank ITU for granting Poland the chance to organize Global Symposium for Regulators. I believe that discussion and debates in such a noble group will result very soon in real action, both globally and nationally. But I also believe that this stay in Poland will be an inspiration to everyone. I encourage you to spend these days in Warsaw as actively as possible. We can enjoy a really nice summer outside. The city is attractive for guests and offers various attractions practically around the clock. And for the dessert on Saturday, I invite you to join me on the trip to the most beautiful cities in the world, Kraków. And last but not least, let me share with you a message for this symposium, which is an anecdote from Einstein's life. Once Einstein was asked about the difference between his intelligence and intelligent other people. He thought a moment and answered. Usually, most people, when they are looking for the needle in the haystack, and find one, they stop looking. When I am looking the needle in the haystack and find one, I am looking for second and third. And when I am lucky, I usually find fourth. So it is my message, and I hope that during symposium we will find as many needles as possible and never stop at the first one. Ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, once more, good morning, welcome in Warsaw. I wish you present state, wonderful stay and fruitful discussion. Thank you very much.